I'll talk about a very important topic for the spinal interventionist, but no one has made an issue about it until now. I'll give you many samples spinal interventionist faces daily. It is a challenging lecture and advanced level, so watch it repeatedly if you don't understand. Please observe the simple x-ray of the patients before the transformer injection procedure. What have you in mind? If you plan to make a left L5 nerve root selection, which level will you make a target? Let's go on a journey with me. You may face the same situation frequently. The MRI scan showed soft disc extrusion to the left paracentral subarticular space at L4-5. Therefore, I set a target at the left L5 subpedicular nerve root. I faced a CM image on AP and oblique view. I frequently confuse and freeze to think about which level the L5 is, yellow one or red one. Transitional vertebra is the culprit for confusing my decision making. The transitional vertebra is characterized by its abnormally large transverse process at the lumbosacral junction. I chose the red arrow target point as you expected, and put the contrast to confirm the foramen and epidural space. It is a simple case of a transitional vertebra. I count down the level from the white arrow level, and L5 is the transitional vertebra. I'll give you another example. Is it the L4 foramen space? Are the red arrows the L5 foramen space? It is the MRI scan of the patients. Does the spondylolisthesis place in the level of L4-5? Let's compare side by side of two MRIs of previous two patients. Is there a difference? It looks like same level of pathology at L4-5, am I right? It is x-ray of the second patient. I count down the level from the white arrow level, and L6 is the transitional vertebra. In the first patient, I targeted the L5 nerve root because of subpedicular narrowing by disc protrusion at L4-5. In the second case, I targeted the L5 foramen space because of foramen stenosis of the right L5-S1. Let's compare side by side of two CM images of the previous two patients. The left one is the imaginary line. Is there a difference? Both targets were one level above the transitional vertebra, but one is L4 and another one is L5. Keep going. I'll give you more examples. The patient has neurogenic claudication in both lower extremities. It is a simple x-ray. There is an anterior displacement of L4 on L5 and sclerosis of L5-S1 subchondral bone. I selected bilateral L5 roots. The patient has left gluteal and calf pain with a positive raised leg test. It may suggest L5 nerve root irritation. It is a simple x-ray. So do I have to target at the level below the transitional vertebra, or do I have to make a selection for the level one level above the transitional vertebra? Which one is the L5 level? If I count down the lumbar vertebra from the L1 at the patient, it is the L5 body. It is the S1 nerve root. Really? Are you sure? It is the functional L6 or S1 nerve root? Have you ever thought about the functionality of the level? So I studied the whole spine image in a patient with a transitional vertebra to know that counting from the L1 is the right for the counting method from the C1 vertebra. I'll count down the lumbar spine from the C1 in the whole spine image and match it to the lumbar only counting method. I count down from the C1 at the patient. So The vertebra at the red arrow is S1 lumbarization. It looks like a lumbar shape, but it's an S1 segment and functionality S1. Let's observe more cases. The 20-year-old man has left gluteal and posterolateral thigh pain with a positive straight leg test. It is a simple X-ray of the lumbar spine. Is the arrow marked segment L5 or S1? I counted down from the C1. So, the vertebra of the red arrow is S1 lumbarization. It looks like a lumbar shape with abnormal morphology of the transverse process. The red marked vertebral segment is the L5 segment. But what if I stimulate the segmental nerve root? Will it produce pain in the L5 territory? I stimulated the segmental nerve root, which caused referred pain at the anterior thigh, meaning it is the L4 nerve root and L4 vertebral body functionality. The stimulation of the lower nerve root produced concordant pain. I believe the morphological level of the segment does not always match the function. I'll show you a case of mismatching from the whole spine counting to the lumbar spine counting. The 51-year-old female complained about severe pain in the lower back in the sitting position. It is a simple X-ray of the lumbar spine. According to the lumbar counting method from L1, the red arrow marked level is L6 or S1. I counted down from the C1. It revealed the red arrow marked the body as L5. When I do the practice without thinking, it should be L5 level morphologically. Do I have to count down from the morphologic L1 or L5 segment? Let's see more. The 60-year-old male complains of a pain in the right lateral thigh and lateral calf with mild positive signs of straight leg raise test. It is a simple X-ray of the lumbar spine. Is the arrow marked segment S1? According to whole spine counting, it is L5 level with sacralization. So, am I doing at the correct level? Is it L4 level? Then, how can I count the level? It is so confusing. There are several ways to count the vertebral body in the transitional lumbosacral vertebra. First, make a standard line of the iliac crest for counting the level. It is a very easy and standard to count the body. Usually, the iliac crest line corresponds to the level of L4-5 disc space. So, the L5 body is just below the iliac crest. Let's observe more cases. It looks clear-cut standard to count the level in a normal lumbar spine. But what about the transitional vertebra? It corresponds to the L5-6 disc space. Iliac crest line cannot be used for counting the transitional vertebra level. Then, how about the promontory in the lateral view? Promontory is the anterior margin of the body of the first sacral vertebra, forming the prominent sacrovertebral angle. It looks promising and is excellent tool for leveling. Watch more. But it is not accurate in the transitional vertebra either, and vague and inaccurate. So it cannot be used to count a level in the transitional vertebra. How about the thoracic 12 ribs? I usually rely on the T12 rib counting method because during the CM procedure, I can scan counting the upper and lower lumbar levels. I cannot ensure it is the correct L5 level with the transitional vertebra, but at least I can constantly regard it as L5 level. The same it is. Count a level in the whole spine image. It is ideal, but not realistic for the interventional procedure. Here are my suggestions. Please accept the ignorance of finding the true levels, but make your own standard. For example, I count down the level from the T12 ribs. Match the level of MRI pathology to the corresponding level on a simple X-ray before the procedure. Find and mark the transitional vertebra before the procedure. Please record the transitional vertebra and target point in the chart and procedure recordings. Please write down the level if you find concordant pain during the procedure. It is one sample of my procedure order. Mark the transitional vertebra and mark a target level below or above the transitional vertebra. Lastly, I'll briefly review the lumbosacral transitional vertebra. The prevalence is reported from 3 to 40% of the population. So I believe the high percentage of prevalence rate. Also, I believe most of it is asymptomatic, but it is important because it is confusing to count the level. It is helpful to understand the Castelvi classification. According to the Castelvi classification, the transitional vertebra has a unilateral or bilateral dysplastic transverse process. The severity of dysplasia is diverse and scores high grades in the severe form of dysplasia of the transverse process. Let's review some types of transitional vertebra. It is a case of the 1B type of transitional vertebra of L6. There is a pseudoarthrosis between the transverse process and adjacent sacral ally. So it is a type 2 transitional vertebra. There is a pseudoarthrosis and complete fusion on another side. So it is a type 4. There is one side dysplasia and fusion in another side. So it is a type 3A. Please keep that in mind. Mark the transitional vertebra and target. Add the relationship between the transitional vertebra to the target in your chart. Don't be startled to encounter an unexpected shape during the procedure, and be ready. It is a challenging lecture and an advanced level, so watch it repeatedly if you don't understand. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.